Imagine a world without the internet. No instant communication, no endless information at your fingertips, no social media. Now, what if I told you that the internet, our lifeline to the world, was born out of failure? The internet, as we know, it didn't begin with a success story. It began with a bold, flawed experiment that had to crash and burn before rising to what it is today. The story of the internet begins in the 1960s, during the height of the Cold War. The U.S. Department of Defense wanted a resilient communication network that could withstand a nuclear strike. They turned to top scientists, hoping to create a system that would keep information flowing even under attack. The U.S. Department of Defense launched a project. This ambitious project was named ARPANET. The goal? To create a network that could securely connect multiple computers across vast distances. It was first used in 1969 and finally decommissioned in 1989. It was a network of computers designed to share information across long distances, a revolutionary concept at the time. If successful, it would lay the groundwork for a new way of connecting the world. However, no one foresaw how this experiment would fail in unexpected ways, and yet spark the beginning of the internet we know today. The first message sent over ARPANET was intended to be the word login. However, after the transmission of the letter L and the letter O, the system crashed. So, the first meaningful message sent over ARPANET was actually LO, which was short for login. But ARPANET was far from perfect. The technology was new, and expectations were high. Engineers thought it could handle multiple users smoothly, but in reality, it stumbled under the weight of basic tasks. Early users reported constant crashes and frustrating data loss. Connections would drop randomly, and speeds were painfully slow by today's standards. This wasn't the flawless system that engineers had envisioned. Instead of giving up, the challenges faced by ARPANET's engineers pushed them to dig deeper. They realized that the only way to make the network work was to redesign its core technology. This led to the development of a groundbreaking concept known as packet switching. Rather than sending data as one large chunk, packet switching allowed data to be broken up into small, manageable packets. These packets could travel independently across the network and reassemble at their destination. Did you know that early ARPANET could only transmit 50 kbps? While today's fiber optics can transmit at speeds over 100 gigabits per second. However, the practical limit for modern fiber optic systems can reach several terabits per second. Back then, sending a single image would take several minutes. And unlike our current internet with billions of users, ARPANET started with just four computers connected to each other. The Advanced Research Projects Agency Network was the first wide-area packet switch network with distributed control and one of the first computer networks to implement the TCP/IP. Both technologies became the technical foundation of the internet. Packet switching was a game changer. It not only solved ARPANET's performance issues, but also became the foundation for the internet we know today. In its early years, ARPANET's impact was both positive and challenging. On one hand, it was groundbreaking, proving that computers could talk to each other across distances. But on the other hand, it was a reminder that technology often begins with rough edges. The glitches, crashes, and slow speeds pushed innovators to look beyond simple fixes. They saw the potential for a global network, but knew it would require a lot more work. It facilitated collaboration and resource sharing among scientists, researchers, and universities. It allowed for remote access to computing resources, which was particularly useful for time-sharing systems. ARPANET also enabled the development of email, which revolutionized communication. Like any early technology, ARPANET had its limitations and challenges. One of the key challenges was ensuring interoperability between different computer systems and networks. Another challenge was scaling the network to accommodate the growing number of users and increasing demand for bandwidth. The legacy of ARPANET is immense. It laid the foundation for the internet, which has become an integral part of modern society. ARPANET's decentralized architecture, packet switching technology, and networking protocols have shaped the way we communicate, access information, and conduct business. It paved the way for countless technological advancements and innovations in computing and communications. ARPANET's lessons didn't go to waste. Over time, researchers developed TCP/IP protocols, making communication more reliable and universal. By the 1980s, this technology allowed networks to expand beyond ARPANET, forming the Internet. In 1989, Tim Berners-Lee invented the World Wide Web, transforming the Internet from a research tool into a network open to the public. This was the beginning of our modern, hyper-connected world. ARPANET's journey shows us that every major breakthrough starts with missteps. The persistence of engineers in the face of failure transformed ARPANET from a failed experiment into the foundation of the modern Internet. From failure to world-changing success, ARPANET's story is a reminder that innovation requires perseverance. Sometimes, the road to greatness is paved with setbacks, and ARPANET's journey to the Internet proves that perfectly.